Hi, I'm Swapnil Bharti, and we are here at the OpenStack Summit in Vancouver, Canada. And today we have with us Roman. Roman, this is the first time we are meeting, so you have to tell us who you are and what are you doing at OpenStack Summit.
Sounds good. So my name is Roman Alexenkov. I've been in the cloud space for a very long time. I've been working for one of the cloud infrastructure companies before called Mirantis. And a year ago, I started my own company and an open source project called Aptamy. So and here I'm at the OpenStack Summit as well as the OpenDev. One of the speakers will be talking more about that project.
What were the reason why you created Aptamy?
Well, we saw a problem and we saw an opportunity to solve that problem, mm-hmm. right? And the problem that we saw is we kind of looked at the spaces. We looked at the CI space and we looked at the CD space. And what we found out that the CI in the CI space, a lot of problems, they have been solved already, right? Everything that starts from your source code, how it's been written, how it's been tested, how it's been published to a binary artifact. So this problem seems to be solved, right? And, but when we saw, the problem was the CD space. When people are trying to deliver applications, right? When they're trying to take all those pieces of code, put them together in large complex applications, they try to run them across multiple environments, multiple clusters. I think that's where we saw a lot of the challenges. And even right now, that's where you see a lot of the companies like Google with Spinnaker, right? And with like Jenkins with pipelines and a lot of tools being built in that area. There's like Concourse and GoCD and a bunch of other tools. And we saw an opportunity in the in that area, and we decided to go for it.
You mentioned the opportunities that you were, but you also mentioned earlier you said, you know, some problems. So what were the problems you were trying to solve?
Right, so here is the definition of the specific problem, right? So if you look at Kubernetes today, mm-hmm. right, like very specific problem. So you have Kubernetes as a container orchestration layer.
Right.
On top of Kubernetes, you have Helm, mm-hmm. right? Which is essentially a package manager.
Right.
Right. But what people want to build on top, they actually want to run more complex applications, right? The multi-component applications. It's an application, it can be 5 components, or we've seen cases where application consists of 50 components, right? And then all of those components, they have to be glued together. Once you bring applications, components have to know about each other and they need to be able to talk to each other, right? So you need to be able to instantiate and deploy that application graph. And then on top of that, you want to run it across multiple environments, multiple clusters. Maybe you want to have some promotion pipelines, how you promote the code from dev to stage to prod, mm-hmm. right? So this whole problem of how you compose applications, complex applications on top of Kubernetes, and how you run them across multiple environments and how you reason about those services and environments, I think this is where we saw an opportunity and we decided to fill in this gap because in our opinion, I think there is a layer missing, right, between Helm and the pipelines which exist on top, which are provided by Jenkins and Concourse and Spinnaker and all the other tools.
And before we wrap, in addition to running this company and coming to these conferences, what else do you do in your free time?
Actually, I do a lot of things. So one of my hobbies is racing.
Mm, okay.
So I race go-karts outdoor.
Okay.
I won one of the like local California championships and I race some like the Challenge of the Americas and US Grand Nationals. So I wouldn't say like super professional, but like on the semi-professional level,
okay.
I do race go-karts. I think family goes without saying, right? And one other thing would be music.
Really?
Okay. Yeah, so I do collect vinyl. I used to be DJing a little bit. Yeah, back in Russia a little bit here. And I'm trying to get into music production with like Ableton and other stuff. So I have a bunch of hobbies.
Okay, so out of these two, which one you like the most? Because they are totally opposite. One, you have to be outdoors and dirty. And one, you have to be very, very tiny, clean, and indoors.
Yes, I think it depends on my mood. So I think those are completely two different things.
And it gives the balance also, right?
Right. And music, you have to be super patient. Sometimes you have to listen to the same loop for hours and days to make it perfect, right? And racing, as you said, is different.
You want to produce music, create music. What does that mean?
You just make your own tracks.
Okay, I thought you were talking about creating a music company.
No, it's a hobby, right? It's
like. So what instruments do you play?
To be honest, I do not play any. Right, so I'm very into the electronic music, like the underground, like house and techno, some of the minimal stuff that comes from, I don't know, Germany or Romania, right? And I've been trying to write something along those lines.
Oh, awesome.
And there's basically no instruments. You just take Ableton Live and take samples. You try to use existing samples, try to use synthesizers to create your own sounds and then build something out of it together.
So since you're very good friends with Boris and Merentes is throwing a party,
yes.
So will you be DJing there?
I will not be DJing in this one, but actually there were OpenStack events. I think one was in San Diego and the other one in San Francisco when I was actually DJing.
That would be cool to see you DJing, you know, in future.
Maybe.
Yeah.
Anyway, I'm taking a break right now.
Yeah. And it was nice talking to you today.
All right, thanks.
Thank you.